Hello friends, welcome to the channel DDR Academy. Today the topic is disinfection types and methods of disinfection. So in this video I am explaining the disinfection, what is disinfection, what are the different types of disinfection and what are the different methods of disinfection or the different disinfectants used. So first, what is disinfection? It is the killing of infectious agents outside the body by direct exposure to chemical or physical agents. So it is the killing of infectious agents outside the body by direct exposure to physical or chemical agents is known as disinfection. Another definition for disinfection is killing the germs of infection and the insects or organism carrying the infection. So disinfection can be the killing the germs of infection and the insects or organism carrying the infection. Then what is disinfectant? Disinfectants are the substances which are used for disinfection. That is the substances that destroy the harmful microbes with the object of preventing the transmission of disease. Substances which destroy the harmful microbes but not usually the spores. Spores are not destroyed. And the objective of using the disinfectant is preventing the transmission of disease. Okay, these are the disinfectants. And there are variety of disinfectants used, that is natural, then physical and chemical agents are used for disinfection. Next is the types of disinfection. First is precurrent disinfection, concurrent disinfection, and terminal disinfection. So there are mainly three types of disinfection. First one is the precurrent disinfection, second one is the concurrent disinfection, and the third is terminal disinfection. So what is precurrent disinfection? Precurrent disinfection, the examples are chlorination of water, pasteurization of milk, mopping of floor with disinfectants. So the example shows that these disinfection methods are used as a preventive measure, or it is used as a prophylactic measure. So the precurrent disinfection can also be called as prophylactic disinfection. So these are done as a preventive measure. The chlorination of water or pasteurization of milk and cleaning floor with disinfectants. This all shows the examples of disinfection done as a prophylactic or a preventive measure. Then second is the concurrent disinfection. What do you mean by concurrent disinfection? This means the application of the disinfective measures as soon as possible after discharge of infectious materials from the body of an infected person. That is the application of disinfective measures as soon as possible after the discharge of infectious materials from the body of an infected person. So this shows that the disinfection is done when a person is ill. That is concurrent disinfection. Disinfection done when a person is ill is known as concurrent disinfection. The aim is to prevent the spread of infection. Or this disinfection is done after the soiling of articles with infectious discharges. Example, disinfection of urine, feces, vomitus, contaminated linen, clothes, hands, dressings, apron, gloves, etc. throughout the course of an illness. That is known as the concurrent disinfection. Disinfection of all the objects used by the person throughout the course of an illness. That is an example of concurrent disinfection. The next is the terminal disinfection. What do you mean by terminal disinfection? Terminal disinfection means application of the disinfective measures after the patient has been removed by death or to a hospital. If the patient is taken to a hospital or if the patient is dead, in such cases, after the death of the patient or after removing the patient to a hospital, whatever disinfective measures we are doing, that is known as the terminal disinfection. So the terminal disinfection is done after the death, recovery or removal of a patient. It is to disinfect rooms, clothes and other articles so that no germs of infection remain. That is, The purpose is to disinfect the rooms, cloths and articles used by the person in order to free of the germs of infection. That is known as the terminal disinfection. Next is the methods of disinfection. There are mainly three methods or three agents are used. First is the natural methods, then physical methods and the chemical methods. Natural methods, then use of physical agents and use of chemical agents. So first is the natural method. Use of natural agents that include sunlight and air. First is the sunlight. Sunlight means the ultraviolet rays of the sunlight is lethal to bacteria and viruses, and so this exposure to sunlight help in disinfecting linen, bedding and furniture. That is sunlight. Second is the air. Air means acts by drying or evaporation of moisture, which is lethal to most bacteria. So the natural agents used include sunlight and air. The next is the physical agents. Physical agents include burning, use of hot air, boiling, autoclaving and radiation. Use of the physical agents are boiling, autoclaving, burning, hot air and radiation. The next is the use of chemical agents. Chemical agents include the use of different components like the phenol and phenol related compounds. Then ammonia related compounds, halogens and use of alcohol. These are the different chemical agents used. So first is phenol and phenol related compounds. That include pure phenol or carbolic acid, crude phenol, cresol, cresol emulsions, chlorhexidine, hexachlorophane and Dettol. Dettol is chloroxylenol. So phenol and phenol related compounds include all these examples like the carbolic acid or pure phenol, then crude phenol, cresol, cresol emulsions, chlorhexidine, hexachlorophane and Dettol. So Dettol is an example of the phenol related or phenol compounds. Then second is the quaternary ammonia compounds. Example, cetrimide and Savlon. Savlon comes under the ammonia compounds, quaternary ammonia compounds. The next is the halogen and their compounds. Example, bleaching powder, then sodium hypochlorite, halazone tablets, iodine, iodophores. These are the examples of halogen and halogen related compounds. Okay, bleaching powder, sodium hypochlorite, halazone tablets, iodine and iodophores. And the last one is the alcohols that include use of ethyl alcohol, isopropyl alcohol, formaldehyde, lime, ethylene oxide. Alcohols include ethyl alcohol, isopropyl alcohol, formaldehyde, lime and ethylene oxide. So these are the different chemical agents used as a method of disinfection. So there are mainly three methods used in disinfection: natural, then physical and the chemical agents. So these are the different types and methods of disinfection. Hope you understood that class. Thank you for watching the video. Also share this video to your friends.